Hey, what's going on, guys? Tubaplyr NegativeAE back where we left off, and we're in the middle of a thing. So the strategy here is to listen to the whole conversation before we go ahead and shoot a bullet. So that's what I'm gonna do. So I'm gonna listen to the whole conversation. I'm gonna try to play this as strategic as possible. Should you kill the first victim in the music room?
What did girlie do?
What did girlie do?
She just broke the window in the music room. And escaped outside.
Escaped outside.
So how did Girlie get from outside the school to the front of the music room? To go back to the music room from outside, you need to go through the entrance hall.
Plus, at the entrance hall, the other four girls should have been there.
Yeah.
At the entrance hall, the girls heard the sound of the window shattering.
No, I don't even need to listen to the whole conversation because I know that's the one I have to hit. Son?
First of all, the sound the girls heard wasn't the window breaking.
If it wasn't the window, then what broke to make that sound?
A vase.
Vase? How low can you go?
After the murder, a broken vase was discovered in the classroom next to the music room.
Yeah.
So the sound of breaking glass that the four girls heard wasn't the music room's window. It was the sound of the vase breaking, probably.
Yeah.
Actually, the murder was nearly finished by the time the four girls met in the entrance hall. Girl E killed the victim.
I'm much more prepared
room,
for this one.
Broke the window and went to the office to get the key. With that key, she locked the music room from the hallway, returned the key to the office, and went back to wait in front of the music room. All she had to do was break the vase in the next door classroom as the four girls met by the entrance hall.
Yeah.
To make them think the murder had just occurred and that the killer had just escaped.
Got it.
So, when the four of them ran over after they heard the sound, girl E acted like she had just rushed over too.
I see. Now the mystery has been solved.
You're very happy.
Wait a minute! The mystery hasn't been solved yet! You haven't determined what the murder weapon was yet.
True. Murder weapon is probably
the
fish tank.
Murder weapon.
We've not. Cool. I went to all the trouble of making this death march, so you've got to stick with it to the end.
What the heck? You're so annoying.
Fine. Let's figure out the weapon. If this keeps up, I'm gonna feel like I need to shit.
Yeah.
Which means I'll feel disgusting.
What?
You're the disgusting one.
I don't know if it feels disgusting.
The weapon is pretty unconventional. The
it's
answer
a fish tank.
Was now then. Will you guys be able to figure it out?
Conventional weapon that also appeared in the game. If we're told we can't advance as long as we don't make that clear, then I'll have to do it. I'll do it. What do you think the murder weapon is? I have no idea. Was I out of line just now? Evan, there's something I need to tell you regarding the white noise and the non-stop debates. Actually very durable. You won't always be able to... Fuck me. Durable white noise will chip away every time you shoot at them with the silencer, but unless you completely destroy them, your time limit will not be replenished. Also, by the way, if your difficulty is sent to gentle, white noise won't appear at all. You get the gist, right? Yeah. It appears the debate is going to get tougher, so I've obtained some very useful information. I heard there's a guy named Gun something. Apparently he has a skill that increases the power of the silencer. Gun something. I wonder who it is. It's Gundam Tanaka. Was I out of line just now? Well, good luck and have fun. Alright, so we gotta listen to the whole conversation. And I'm gonna go with Broken Fish Tank. Cause that's the murder weapon.
A weapon inside the music room, huh?
Yeah.
What about broken glass?
Isn't the cause of death a blow to the head?
Yes.
Then she attacked her with the fish tank.
Yep.
That's too big to be a weapon.
Fuck. I think that's the one.
Then the piano.
Why are you going even bigger?
No, it's not the piano.
Investigation conducts universal chaos.
Yeah.
It's on that big a scale, too?
How about beating her with gravel instead?
Crap. I should listen to the whole conversation. I'm just too shooty.
A weapon inside the music.
All right, so I had to look this one up. Because freaking, I was at the. I literally been playing this for an hour and 30 minutes before I was like, you know what? Fuck it. I have to look it up.
With the fish tank.
So it's evidently it's Storm's cool swimsuit on the line where Ibuki says something about.
Are you going even? The investigation conducts universal. It's on
she
that
says something about gravel.
Too?
And you have to fucking.
How about beating her with gravel instead?
Like that, like I was gonna effing freaking know that. How was I supposed to know that the swimsuit had anything to do with the gravel?
I got it. The killer must have used gravel to attack the victim.
Like how the.
My goodness, I got it right, and I was just throwing things out there.
Yeah, I honestly had no idea that was the thing either.
Just as I thought, I'm chosen by the
gods.
It
was frustrating as balls, dude.
You're not chosen at all, and gravel is impossible. It's too small to be a weapon.
What if the gravel was put inside some sort of bag?
What kind of bag?
If the weapon is something that appeared in the game, and so is the bag. And the only thing I can think of is the school swimsuit.
It was so dumb. How the fuck was I supposed to know?
If you tie the swimsuit like a bag and stuff it full of gravel, it'd make an effective weapon.
Gravel inside the swimsuit? Even the ace attorney would be
I feel
astonished
like
by such a fantastic
like it's like
idea.
A really far answer to that.
Before the killer,
whatever.
It's an idea that kills two birds with one stone. To make people think the killer is
an hour and 30 minutes on
it makes
show.
Sense for a school swimsuit to be stolen. And if that swimsuit was used to make an improvised weapon, it'd have to be disposed of later.
How about it, Monokuma? Are you satisfied now?
This happiness you feel when the mystery you create is solved. Only producers know this feeling.
But the real important
angry.
Talk begins
I'm just angry
now.
This whole time. Gosh darn it.
Girl E had someone who can be called an accomplice. That person was actually Girl D.
Girl D. You're talking about Mahiru, right?
Huh? Mahiru is the accomplice? What is this? What does that mean?
The piece of face that became an important clue in the music room murder. Girl D got rid of it.
And
yeah.
Apparently the reason Girl E committed murder in the first place was to protect Girl D. Girl D was being harassed by the victim. Girl E found out and tried to stop it. And they ended up getting into an argument.
And she felt a rush of anger and ended up killing her.
But she should have had a clear murderous intent. I mean, she choked her out and then bludgeoned her to death.
She probably made her unconscious by accident. From there, she couldn't go back. I somewhat understand that feeling.
You can? That's pretty scary.
But Girl E was also killed by someone on the fourth day. Or the game's last day. I might as well ask just in case. Who do you think killed?
It was definitely the guy.
I see!
It should have been Guy F.
Non-stop
a scenario
debates.
Where Guy F murders Girl E out of a burning, hellfire desire to avenge his murdered sister.
But Guy F is...
What?
It's just a story in a video game, isn't it?
That's all you can say. If that game is telling the truth, it'd be a huge problem for you.
Hey, clear this up for me. Those of you who appeared as characters in the game, do you remember this incident?
I'm terribly sorry, but...
They don't remember! That's obvious! Because their school memories were, like, totally stolen!
Huh.
Even if I don't remember, I already know! It's obvious that guy is the killer! No one would kill a nice person like Mahiru besides a piece of shit menace to society like Fuyuhiko! Girl E and Mahiru were killed by that guy!
You sure do talk a lot of shit. Well, I'm used to it by now.
Does Mahiru's murder have anything to do with that game? Perhaps the two are unrelated.
I like how what's-his-name's picture is knives and forks. Connected. In actuality, there's an important shared point with Girl E and Mahu's murder. The bat.
I can prove it with this.
The bat. Yes. Good.
I'm not sure the two things are unrelated.
No more cutting for me. Until we get into another non-stop debate.
As proof, Mahiru, who was killed in the beach house, and Girl E, who was killed in the game, were both killed by a blow to the head with a metal bat. There's no way we can ignore that connection.
Someone must have wanted to split her head open the exact same way they avenged the first victim. Hey, why don't you confess already? You're the one who killed Mahiru, right?
You better cut that out right now! There is no way a stupid game could be the motive!
You're dumb enough to believe that stupid game, and that's why you killed her as revenge!
If you keep making up your mind like that, we're just gonna go around in circles. And it's true Fuyuhiko may look suspicious. Don't you think that'd be too obvious?
What are you...
I mean, there's a possibility that it's a trap set by the true killer.
I agree.
Trap?
That's what I was
thinking. The true killer played that game. And most likely found out about the relationships between the characters. That person could be using that knowledge to try to set up for Fuyuhiko.
Are you saying that a completely different killer murdered Mahiru and used the game motive as their cover?
It's looking to be Sonya, never mind.
Huh? Don't you understand? I'm saying you
might her.
What is this? Like, I can only laugh. What are you even saying, you
it's
nasty?
It's gonna make me think
that
it's her, but it's not. Alright, I hope I won't have to skip this one. Something from the beach, metal can showroom. Let's stick with, something from the beach.
What are you saying, you four-eyed troll? Accusing me of killing Mahiru? You're so mean!
Why do you doubt Hyoko?
Do you know where Hyoko was today?
Yeah.
She was at the beach house, the scene of the crime.
I agree. Oh, jeez.
Damn it!
Oh, no. I'm only a couple minutes in after my cut.
Accusing me of killing Mahiru?
Why do you doubt? Do you know where Hyoko? She was at the beach house.
But I didn't go to the beach house! I was squishing Mr. Ants all day!
Okay, wait, so she
what
definitely it's that ending statement that she makes.
Do you know where Hyoko she was at the beach house, the scene of the crime.
So I'm gonna need to
but
clear
I didn't
this
go
out.
To the beach house.
No, that's wrong.
No, she definitely did. She was definitely at the beach house. Whew, I'm glad that didn't take an hour and 30 minutes.
Seriously, I told you I didn't.
But these footprints in the sand in front of the beach house, aren't they yours?
I don't have such ugly footprints. They're probably Mikan's based on how ugly they are.
Don't decide that based on ugliness.
They're not Hyoko's footprints? That's strange. The footprint I collected from your room matches these footprints perfectly.
Collected? I never gave you permission to collect that, you...
Plus, the foot, which means...
I don't think it's her.
...and the owner of these footprints are different.
Are you talking about the door facing the road that Mahiru's body was in?
Are you saying when that person went inside the beach house, the body hadn't appeared yet?
The door was still accessible when they went in, and wasn't when they left.
Which means something happened between those two events. Isn't that right, Hyoko?
Hyoko wouldn't run away crying, and Hyoko wouldn't kill Mahiru because...
I remember now! I remember when I went to the beach house!
So you finally decided to confess.
I'm pretty sure you guys already know this, but going for walks in the morning is my daily routine.
I've never heard of that daily routine before!
And that's when I went to the beach house! I went there on my morning walk!
I see. If you went there during your morning walk, that doesn't have anything to do with the case at
That's
all.
That's not true, because she went, she invited
Don't
Mahiru.
Believe her so easily, dumbass! She's obviously lying!
She is.
Huh? It's a lie? People who call other people liars are usually liars themselves. If you say I'm lying, prove it.
Can you even prove that I'm lying? There's no way a bunch of worthless idiots like you guys would be able to do that.
Why is she lying? I don't understand why she's lying. Okay, letter on Mahiru is where I think this conversation's going.
I did go to the beach house, but only during my morning walk.
No.
No, that's wrong.
Glad that was over real quick. I hate nonstop.
Only during your morning walk, huh? Will you still claim that after you take a look at this letter?
I wanted to tell you in person, but I couldn't find you, so I put this in your mailbox. About what we discussed earlier, is it okay if we change the place and time? I want you to come by the beach house on the second island at 2:30 p.m. There's someone who wants to interfere with our meeting. Let's keep it a secret. Until then, let's try not to see each other for a while. It'd be bad if they started suspecting us for no reason.
That letter! It's the one Mahiru!
I see. So Kyoko was able to arrange a meeting with Mahiru by exchanging letters with him.
What is that letter? I'm serious. I don't know.
Oh, snap. I remember now. I totally saw you.
Huh?
Me and Hajime met up at the diner around 3 p.m. to go to the beach. I saw you about 30 minutes later, so it should have been around 3:30 p.m.
So if she met Mahiru at 2:30 p.m.
She might have been the killer.
Then ran away afterward.
She couldn't have discovered the body. Because if she would have discovered the body, Monokuma should have ended it right there. Like, oh, body's been discovered. And it didn't happen because she died at 3. So she might have been the killer? She's a killer, though. I don't know.
I think 3:30 p.m. is a reasonable time for you to have witnessed him. You're wrong! You're totally wrong!
I don't think Kyoko Sayonji would kill Mahi.
Now that you mention it, you also passed by the diner Fuyuhiko. So you should have seen Kyoko too, right?
No, I didn't. It's just a coincidence that I passed by the diner. I wasn't even paying attention to the beach house. I went straight back to my cottage after I saw you guys. I didn't see anyone during that time.
For some reason, that sounds suspicious too.
It does kinda.
It's the truth. Deal with it.
Just leave him alone.
I don't think either Sanji or... I think Pekka's a pretty...
That letter in Kazuichi's testimony says it all.
Pekka's a pretty interesting subject here.
Seriously? I don't know! I didn't even write that letter!
I believe you. I'm thinking it is...
I'm telling the truth! I really, really don't know!
Okay, so I'm thinking it's Pekka. The reason why I think it's Pekka is because Sayonji wouldn't kill Mahiru. It's not any of the people they have suspected already, because that's how the last trial went. It wasn't any of the
people
they suspected.
Is she crying? Or is she faking?
She's probably faking it.
We can assume she summoned Mahiru.
And Pekka's doing exactly what she said she would. And then all the water bottles.
She wrote a letter to let her know where to meet. So, and then you went ahead to the beach house. Hid yourself in a specific...
No.
There's evidence for that too.
No, yeah, I know there is, but... It's the closet. It's this thing, because this thing goes to the closet.
Here!
Yeah, she was hiding. She probably...
The place where Hiyoko was hiding. Are you talking about the closet?
Yes, that's right. The gummy candy we found on the floor is the evidence. Hiyoko. What's a gummy? I've never eaten something like that.
I have captured the true Hiyoko who summoned Mahiru to the beach house.
It's not true.
Hid inside the... When she saw her chance,
no,
she attacked
Pekka.
Her like an evil spirit.
Pekka's the one that killed her, even though I don't understand her motive. It's Pekka. Gotta be.
But Hiyoko miscalculated that Mahiru's body would be blocking the door at that time. Because of that, she was only able to leave from the beachside door.
She wouldn't kill. She wouldn't kill Mahiru.
My four dark devas of destruction didn't even need to come out.
You guys.
It's a trap. This is obviously someone's trap.
I agree. I
someone. Whose trap is it?
It must be that one person.
You know, the one with the mask, maybe?
Sanji, it's not you.
There was a suspicious mask at the beach house, right? Whoever was wearing that could be the real killer.
Yeah.
You're the one who wore that mask and killed Mahiru.
There's no way I'd wear such a childish mask. Is your brain fried or something?
That is right. It cannot be Hyoko. That mask belongs to Sparkling Justice.
Or Sonya, never mind. I can't leave out Sonya, never mind. It could be Pekko or Sonya, never mind.
Huh? Sparkling what now?
Because Sonya, never mind, was late and she was getting a swimsuit.
That mask says it all. Sparkling Justice is hiding on this island, which means the legendary serial killer Sparkling Justice is the one who killed Mahiru.
Why, you? If you continue to say such foolish things, I shall tear you limb from limb.
Don't blame this, Sonya! It's just a difference between cultures. Culture shock, you know?
Yoko, why don't you just admit it already? You're being
a... Shut your head!
I agree.
Oh, why can't you understand? I'm not the killer!
I know. Something strange. Something doesn't make sense. I can't help for being directed by someone. It's Pekko. Definitely Pekko. Alright, so we're going with the trash can because it's where the water came from. I'm thinking that she's poured water on herself.
I shall render my verdict upon this mystery's conclusion.
Let's listen to the whole conversation.
Hyoko is the sinner who Let's killed Mahiru.
I'm telling you, it's a trap!
Okay.
Yeah, there's no doubt.
Nope.
You went to the beach house, right?
Yeah. Yes,
you
did.
And weren't you also hiding in the closet?
Yeah, she was.
So that's when you dropped the gummy. You waited for your chance to kill Mahiru. And afterward, you fled from the beach house.
At the time, the girl facing the road was blocked by the body.
Yeah.
So you were forced to flee from the beachside entrance.
And that's how you left your footprints.
So that's when you drop the gun. No, that's wrong.
I don't know. Like, I try to think of stuff.
About there we go. Gun, did Hyoko really drop it?
The only one childish enough to eat gummies is that midget over there.
You're a midget too, you know.
It's true, Hyoko likes to eat gummies. But she only eats a specific brand.
Why would Pekko kill Mahiru?
The brand of gummies you eat only have strawberry, melon, grape, and orange flavors, right?
What about the lemon flavor? The gummy at the crime scene is yellow, so it obviously looked like it was lemon flavor.
Huh? That gummy is yellow? And it's not mine! The ones I eat don't have any yellow gummies!
That's right. None of the gummy bags in her cottage had any yellow ones.
Then we can't assume Hyoko is the one who...
See? Didn't I tell you? It's definitely a trap!
Damn it! Who would set a trap like this?
And Pekko would be able to get out through the window, or get in through the window.
I'll get my revenge! I'm gonna bop you on the
because
head
she has a
with
sword.
All my might!
Hold on, you little bitch! You think you're in the clear just because of a little gummy? Don't be stupid! I'm not done backing you into a corner yet!
Oh, shit.
We're not done with Hyoko yet. There's still a huge piece of evidence left.
You're talking about the footprints near the beach house, right?
It's true. That's an important piece of evidence. And we can thank Mahiru for it.
What does that mean?
Mahiru used her last ounce of strength and blocked the door to the road. Thanks to her, we have the evidence we need.
That's wrong. I left those footprints during my morning walk.
We're not done with Hyoko yet. There's still a huge...
You're talking about the footprints.
It's true, that's an important... We can thank Mahiru for it!
What does that mean?
Mahiru used her last ounce of strength and...
Boom. No, that's wrong!
My first shot, son. That was my first shot. I don't know, speed ahead against it because I don't want you guys to like watch through all that.
Her death was instant.
Instant death? According to my autopsy, yes, there's no doubt that Mahiru died instantly.
If you keep making shit up, I'll fucking kill you!
I'm sorry!
Ryuhiko, you cannot do that. Only a coward threatens women.
I'm pretty sure her death was instant, too. I mean, her injury was only a single blow. That's why Mahiru isn't the one who blocked the door. Someone else used her body to block it.
Someone else?
The killer, of course. They're the one who blocked the door with Mahiru's body. That's why there were bloody drag marks left on the floor.
Yes.
But why did the killer block the door?
Just ask Kyoko. She's the killer, after all.
She's not.
Seriously? That's not true!
It's Pekka.
Let's assume Hiyoko is the killer. Wouldn't that mean she's also the one who dragged the body? If she handled the body that bloody, I think her clothes or skin would have been stained with blood.
And that's why Hiyoko is the killer, because she freaking was wet. Game, set, match. I found the killer. Early, before they even revealed who it was. Pekka arrived after this moment.
I told you I wasn't the killer!
I narrowed it down to five people. Chiaki, Gundam, Sonya Nevermind, Yuhiko, Nekomaru, and Sword. The only reason I didn't suspect Sword at first is because she said she was swimming and she was wet.
With this, my innocence has been proven!
I won't let you look down on me!
Oh, dude, you're wrong.
We haven't decided that yet.
Hey, Fuyuhiko, why do you keep insisting that Hiyoko is the killer?
Shut up! I'm telling you, she's the killer! That little bitch is definitely the killer!
Okay. Let's go. Footprints on the beach, showroom. Shower room.
If Mahiru didn't block the door, then Hiyoko did it. She killed Mahiru and blocked the door with her body. Hiyoko is the only killer I can think of.
Do I really have to freaking...
If Mahiru didn't block the door, then Hiyoko did it. She killed Mahiru and blocked the door with her body. Hiyoko is the only killer I can think of.
Are you kidding me?
If Mahiru didn't block the door, then Hiyoko did it. She killed Mahiru and blocked the door with her body. Hiyoko is the only killer I can think of.
Oh my goodness.
If Hiyoko moved the body, then she should be covered in blood.
So what, dumbass? There's a shower room inside the beach. After she moved the body, she just washed it off in the shower. Allow me to
Boom,
cut through
sorry.
Those words.
Allow me to cut through those words. Allow me to just cut through.
Now,
just a little bit.
Washing
there.
It off in the shower is impossible.
Just
because
a little
the shower
bit.
In the beach house.
Out of.
I'm terribly sorry. I haven't had any time to actually repair it.
Then maybe she took her clothes off to move the body, and when she was done, she put them back on.
Nope.
Are you saying I did something that perverted?
No, that's impossible. She can't get undressed by herself.
Damn it!
Oh no, she can't get dressed by herself.
I see!
Because she needs to tie the bow.
Listen to me, Fuyuhiko. Hiyoko mentioned this before. Which means, Hiyoko can't change by herself. It's impossible for her to put on and take off her clothes.
Oh yeah, she couldn't even tie her sash on her own. That's why she couldn't take a bath and smell bad.
I didn't smell. I only smelled a little.
Oh, wasn't changing inside the beach house prohibited in the first place?
Yeah.
Yes, if you broke the rules, I'm pretty sure Monokuma wouldn't have kept quiet.
Damn right! I'm such a stickler for the rules that even Safari Park Rangers want nothing to do with me! If she didn't change her clothes, then what did Hiyoko do with the blood that got on her?
She
like I've been saying, the blood wasn't on me in the first place, because
I never touched Mahiru's body!
I agree.
If you think about it the other way around, does that mean whoever was covered in blood is suspicious?
Yeah. No. No, you're...
Because if so, I believe Akane was soaked with
blood. Yeah, but she had wounds.
Didn't I tell you that was because I got beat up by Coach Nekomaru?
I can attest to that. If I hadn't gotten that rough with her, she never would have backed down.
Doubting me of all people. You got some nerve. All right, I'll bend your body in half so you're stuck in a bowing position for the rest of your life. That actually sounds pretty cool.
It's actually Pekko.
Right? The hell it does.
Hey, more importantly, I'm okay now, right? It's okay that I'm not the killer?
Yeah, seems like it.
See, I already told you. There's no way I'd kill Mahiru.
That's the thing that I was thinking the entire time.
Mahiru taught me how to wear a kimono, and she was very, very kind. There's no way I would kill a nice person like her! Why wouldn't you believe me earlier? You guys are stupid! Stupid, stupid, stupid!
Hyoko, please don't cry. Everything is fine now, right?
Shut the hell up, pig barf! I hope you get a hangnail and die!
She's like the internet.
And I'm sorry for being pig barf.
It's not Fuhiko. They're putting blame on people that it's not. Okay. Getting so worked up in Hyoko being suspicious. It's Pekko. It's definitely Pekko, and it makes complete sense why it's Pekko, because she poured herself with water and she's the one that killed everybody. And if she's not the killer, I'll be surprised. I'll be super surprised. Honestly, if they can pull something out of their ass to where it's not Pekko, I'll be completely surprised. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. I'm going to end it here because I don't know how long the edits are going to be. If you guys enjoyed the video, make sure you leave a like. If you didn't, let me know. Subscribe if you feel necessary. Leave a comment if you want to have a conversation, because that's how we do. Hope you guys are having a good rest of your day. Peace out, guys.